Well, I do want to talk about the budget because the city is projected to have a revenue shortfall of $224 million beginning in 2025, which is right around the corner. Because we're mandated by the state to pass a balanced budget, our options to address this upcoming deficit are either raise revenue, cut services, or some combination of the two. Mm-hmm. Which one will be your approach to address this budget shortfall?
Well, we absolutely have to raise revenue. So in the last budget cycle, we had a proposed amendment to do a modest increase of the Jumpstart payroll expense tax. That was something that I supported. It did not pass, but I do think we're going to have to look at that again. we are a growing city. In the last 20 years, we grew, I think, twice as fast as anybody anticipated. And so that means that we have increased need in the city, whether that's infrastructure or service needs to make sure that our neighbors are getting the kind of public service that they deserve. And we have to be able to pay for that. So I do think that we will have to have a conversation about increasing the payroll expense tax. We're also looking at a capital gains tax. I think that will be part of the conversation we have this budget cycle. The thing is that this is not new information for the city. There was a progressive revenue committee that was formed in 2017, 2018 that started looking at these issues. Mayor Harrell had another task force in the last year to continue that conversation, but the recommendations are the same, which is that as a growing city, given the constraints that we have at the state level, we do have to contemplate how else we will raise revenue to be able to serve our community. And increasing revenue, particularly on large corporations, is, in my opinion, and the opinion of many of my colleagues, the way for us to go.
Certainly, the Jumpstart tax was a popular policy, not just with the city council, but with the residents of Seattle. So looking at expanding that is definitely an option on the table. Are there still going to have to be cuts? Will those, even if we were to successfully generate more revenue with both of those, does that cover that shortfall, or will there also need to be some cuts?
We are absolutely looking at the possibility of having to reduce the budget next year. And the challenge is that it is, something like $140 million next year, and it will be even more than that the following biennium. And so how we address that is going to be part of the conversation we start this budget cycle. How we address the staffing of the city is going to be a really hard conversation, because what I fear is that, the departments where, there's been a lot of work done to recruit new people into the city, to make sure that we're diversifying our city workforce. And I want to make sure that if we get to a point where we have to have staff layoffs, that those new folks who are mostly people of color who have come in are not going to be the first people to go. So it's going to be hard conversations. We are just now starting to think about the strategy for dealing with what those conversations are going to have to look like over the next year.